Did blue. Last game, Goldcoin United had selected red, and that's why I thought they were going to counterpick. Right, it's different. And look at this, TL.
If it ain't broke, yeah. Don't fix it. Shen going to be banned away again.
But the order.
Team Liquid knows the power of globals.
Yeah.
Team Liquid is not allowing their opponents to have a global.
Yeah. And it's interesting. So they still ban the Renekton, maybe the Malzahar. Camille comes through, like the adaptation here. The Elise or the Karma won't come through. The Lulu, I think, also does from Goldcoin United.
Have to see what they decide to do for the third phase, but Lorlo is going to have to play something a little bit different this time. They want to at least make him change up the split push game if that's what he's going to continue doing, or maybe just get him back on more of a tank. Malzahar banned away. Same ban as we've been seeing previously.
Yep, I think Lulu comes through here for Goldcoin United. And then first, oh, okay.
All right. So that means Team Liquid can first pick Lulu.
Okay, so I was saying, like, if you ban the Camille, they take Rumble. But if you ban Rumble, they take Camille. If you ban both, they can't take either, but they'll take Lulu gladly.
Oh, yeah.
Which means you Rengar?
Any day of the week, they'll take that Lulu. That's such a strong pick right now, especially when you've got somebody like Double Lift who can be that massive hyper carry with the Lulu, giving him the wild growth, giving him the health picks, polymorphing anybody who dives on him. All the tools you need are right there in the box to make everything work out perfectly. As Rainover's thinking about the Nidalee here in game number three, his opponents have already grabbed Nautilus and Rengar on the side of Goldcoin unit.
Yeah, Rainover, Elise, Kha'Zix still up. I don't think he goes for Nidalee. He hovers the Nidalee kind of because I know Nidalee has actually given him like wrist problems in the past because of how much he has to spam buttons while clearing camps to have your efficiency be high, whereas Elise, it's kind of like, kind of hit my W, kind of hit my Q.
Throw a spider at them, throw some spit at them,
yeah,
eat them.
There's a lot more motion involved in your mouse hand and also in your left hand in terms of timing for hitting the keys when you're playing Nidalee, so hovers that.
All right.
Doesn't want to pick it.
Team Liquid, they decide to go for Kha'Zix. Now remember, this has been played in both previous games by Santorin, both times losses, so Rainover going to see if he can show Goldcoin how Kha'Zix is supposed
Ooh,
to be done.
Ocean.
As they lock in the Ezreal for Double Lift, and Goldcoin decides to respond with a Lucian for Mash.
Yeah, get the Lucian in there. We'll see, because this is an interesting matchup. You can do a lot of damage on this Lucian, be incredibly mobile. It's Mash, though, and I like this. Finally, the Karthus ban.
The Karthus is banned away. No, you are not allowed to play it a third time in a row, Piglet. That's going to be shut down. Very important there from Goldcoin United in this second part of the bans. Nami will be the ban from Team Liquid. They can target that support role. Goldcoin really can't because the support's already been picked on the side of Liquid. Mm-hmm. This is the third time, Zyrene, that we're seeing lopsided first drafting phases, I should say.
Yeah, and I like that. I like that they're going for some other things and throwing others off. So now they have the Nautilus top, no Camille, no Rengar, or sorry, no Camille, no Rumble, no Shen, no Renekton to play into it. And it's definitely the superior tank in the top lane. Taking the Gragas away, which can be a good matchup for the Nautilus, is good as well. But they're leaving so much up here for Piglet. So I assume you counterpick here. Team
you
Liquid.
Have to.
Team Liquid, they can't ban Zyra and Karma both. You'll get one of them. You pick one of them here for GCU, and then you ban, or then you wait for the other picks to come through, and then you counterpick mid and give Phoenix a matchup that he can decimate in.
And that's what he needs to do. You need to put Piglet where he can't really have any sort of an influence in this game. Put him in one of those games that we've seen him in saying, you know, this is a result of Piglet doing the recent role swap. This is him in a spot that he needs more time to adapt to. That's what Goldcoin United needs. Thinking about the Ahri there for a second.
I was like, hell no.
Yeah, no, absolutely not. Don't tap the brakes, slam those.
It's like, don't do that three times in a row because right now, Cassiopeia is on the table. Even Ryze, which some people have been playing, Cassiopeia, Vladimir, Victor, Ryze, Orianna, there's just so much mid. If you pick something early like that Ahri, just stop.
Just stop. It's time to stop. All right, they pick up the Karma instead, like you predicted. Either the Zyra or the Karma would be picked up, and they will go for the more supporty of the supports as opposed to the damage dealer. As Fizz is locked in for Liquid, you don't get Camille. Instead, you're going to be getting Fizz.
Yeah, and so this means that for Goldcoin United's side, it's most likely an AP mid laner, maybe not an AD here, whereas here for Team Liquid, they definitely need an AP mid. And the Ahri has been that suit, and it's why they've been taking it away from Piglet, is because it's such a comfort champion for him.
It really is.
But right here, Vladimir, Orianna, Victor, Cassiopeia.
Was it you I was talking to that was describing to me how sometimes Team Liquid will have comms and Piglet will be like, is this a good game for Ahri? Can I play Ahri here? Can I do Ahri? And they're like, No, no, this isn't an Ahri game. He really likes playing the Ahri.
Every time.
Ahri? 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 No, this time, Ahri? 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 No, no. Ahri? 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 You sure? Ahri? Nope, okay.
Karthus.
But this time around, he is on Ahri. Phoenix is going to be on Vlad, though, and we have seen Vlad tear up some games recently in
yeah.
American LCS.
Vladimir also having the Karma alongside him is a great combination to speed him up. He doesn't have to take the Ghost anymore because it takes 2 seconds to ramp up that movement speed. So Vladimir's have been going for the Ignites now and trying to go for a little more kill pressure. Deathfire, Touch, sometimes Storm Raider Surge for the movement speed. But we'll see what ends up happening here because this is definitely a matchup that Phoenix can crush. Well, we'll see how Piglet does, because this is still comfort for him, and his champion pool really didn't get pinched this game.
And you know, I talked last game's Irene about how much I like Infernal Drakes. I also like Ignites. I'm really glad that we nerfed Exhaust, because now everybody takes Ignites instead, and they just kill each other that much more often. You've got an Ignite on the Lulu, you've got an Ignite on both mid laners, and by the way, Lorlo topside, Ignite TP.
Yep, the Fizz with Ignite Teleport. We'll go Trandy Force first. He'll have the Bruiser damage on the W, making sure that he gets triple every few seconds.
Three Ignites against Vladimir
yeah.
makes life pretty tough for Phoenix.
Feels bad, man, but we'll see here because Team Liquid, they want to feel good being in the LCS and not have to play tomorrow.
Oh, absolutely. Just being able to take that day off. You can go out. You can go to bed tonight relaxed, confident, relieved that you don't have to play in the match tomorrow. Because, I mean, nerves can definitely be a thing in these types of games, right? It can happen to anybody. You're on stage and it's literally the difference of, hey, do you want to play in LCS next split? If so, win this.
And this is what these two teams have been playing for the last few weeks to get to this moment for Team Liquid and to potentially avoid this moment for GCU. But if they were in this moment, they're going to need the reverse sweep. They've been practicing for this. This is what it all amounts to right here, the chance for the LCS.
Well, you know, I would argue that Team Liquid was also actually playing to avoid this moment, as in being in this tournament altogether the past couple of weeks.
I will say but they started making some adjustments in terms of moving people around, getting new coaches. And you're right, they were trying to avoid relegation, but
now that you're here, you got to play the hand you're dealt.
Eventually just said, okay, now that we're locked in, we got to win.
All right, Santorin and Madlife, bottom side there, just bringing Santorin down to see if there's any sort of a weird level one fight in this game number three. There's not going to be, though.
Yeah, but that gets wards on his red and his Raptor start, so he will be spotted.
You know, this Fizz skin is really freaky to me, Zyrene, because that rabbit shark thing comes up out of the ground, and it's it's like some Nightmare Before Christmas, like Tim Burton shark fish with these really wonky teeth. The first time I ever saw it, I was like, what in the world?
No, dude, it Watership Down.
Watership
Down? You ever see that movie? The cartoon?
I had no idea this was even a thing.
Oh, no. Wait, it has rabid bunnies.
What the heck?
There's like Watership Down is a very tragic story as well, but about hero building and all of that, but it's a cartoon that gave me nightmares, and that's what it reminds me of, is that rabbit is the big one from Watership Down.
Fan vote at the bottom part of your screen there for the third time today, finally in the favor of Liquid. It changed 7% between games 1 and 2. It's going to change 3% more here between games 2 and 3, as 53% of the fans think that Liquid will walk away with this one. Lorlo finds Solo there. The shield can block up some of the damage, as Matt takes a lot of hurt here at level one.
And you saw that as well. Some people don't know this about Fizz because they haven't seen it. He'll hit you and then like carrot on top of him with the skin, fills up. And when it's filled, that's when you'll do triple damage on your activate of your Q, or of your W. So you have to hit them and then wait a few seconds.
And then you activate
then
it.
Then triple damage, trident spear them in
give
the chest.
The big carrot.
Yeah.
Yeah, gotta be really careful about Lorlo too if you're solo, always remembering that he's got that ignite potential, because that could be the difference between something that you would otherwise walk away from or not. So
yeah,
always got to be in the back of your head.
It's that carry top lane potential that he has. Santorin though, clearing this out. He was spotted. There's a ward right in his Krug pit, so they know that he cleared it. It actually just died, I believe.
Well, Santorin getting back. You can see Pink there on the bottom side as double lift makes his way up the river just to drop a ward off real quick.
Yep, making sure that the blast cone is dead. That's a thing that a lot of people don't do. You ward, and depending on how far you think the jungler has come, that's where you ward. So he felt like maybe Santorin could be there, which is strange because I thought they saw him on the Krugs. So it's not a deep ward. And instead, goes for placing the ward around the blue and then killing the blast cone. Kill the plants in the enemy jungle.
Always kill those whenever you can. Yeah. The Scryer's Bloom is right there.
It just spawned afterwards, so.
Right. Oh, Phoenix.
Phoenix.
All right, he's not going to die from that, but that was very aggressive from Piglet.
Very aggressive. The Ignite comes out as well. A Phoenix still CSing better. Ah, I like that. He taps the E to make sure that all of the caster minions are one turret shot plus one Vladimir auto attack away from being killed.
All about that CSing up under the turret to keep those numbers as high as they can possibly be. 24 to 15 right now, so feeling pretty good. Health already coming back up. That's the nice part about Vladimir. You can just pop a couple of those biscuits, get yourself healed up with your transfusions as well, and all of a sudden it's like Piglet never even ignited you.
Yep, and now he has that summoner spell on cooldown, so Piglet can't really go for that all in for a bit here. Madlife, interesting position.
Well, Mash and Madlife both going to have to back away after that one, taking a lot of damage. And as Lorlo continues to shove up topside too.
And there's so much value in this blue side pick for Team Liquid because they're just forcing certain bans. Santorin though, nice place of the ward there from Lorlo, so he's not at all visible by the Rengar. And now Rainover's going to go.
Rainover says hello, but so does the Blast Cone. Santorin getting himself away to safety on that one. Good reaction, making sure that he got himself out before anything worse happened.
Sticking around though, places another ward. And yeah, Grasp of the Undying for the top lane Bruiser Fizz, because you're in combat for a long time. It's a long combat pattern. It's not the same as like an AP Fizz where you shark somebody and then they actually die just
shark. Just to give them, yeah.
This is more of you got to poke them a few times, you know, soften them up.
Get them with the stick. Or the carrot, or whatever it is.
Yeah. Lorlo. Goes in level 5.
Tries to jump in, immediately jumps right back out. Solo's very low on mana, but Lorlo doesn't exactly have a ton of HP to work with right now either. Rainover will show himself mid lane as he just walks on through. Not really a chance to do anything against Phoenix here. No level 6 on Piglet means that the chances of killing a Vlad are pretty low.
Yeah, and we're seeing these skill differences here in these matchups where Mash and Madlife don't have that same bully lane where they just shove you in with a Caitlyn and a Zyra, and he's down 10 CS right now. Whereas mid lane, we don't have that Karthus coming through where you can play on the back foot, and Piglet down about 10 CS. So we're seeing the actual skill discrepancies here between these different laners on these champions. Because before, it did feel like, also I would say GCU had a bit of a crutch for themselves by having the Zyra, because Doublelift was staying even in CS in a lane that you shouldn't be winning, because he had Tahm Kench.
Yeah, that was the fact that the Tahm Kench didn't gib them any more in the lane than it did was really impressive from the Team Liquid bottom lane. This time around, though, no kills, no anything on the board, but already an 600 gold lead for Team Liquid. The farm they're putting up just across the board, sans mid lane, is fantastic. That mid lane, the only point of falling behind, but like you talked about in Champion Select, that's really what Gold Coin needed to see this game, taking away the Karthus from Piglet, putting him into a matchup where Phoenix is going to win.
Ooh, Solo couldn't get the auto attack for the root off there, and now he's going to have to blow some potions and actually be very wary because he doesn't know exactly where Rainover is. So he's playing super safe. And right now, it's going to be Lorlo going and just warding the red. This is, once again, Lorlo-Rainover synergy. Rainover synergizing with his top laner. And this is most likely something that got kind of taught to Lorlo, I would assume, on carry champions is, hey, when this is happening and you see the gray, go ahead and ward it. I'll have a little bit of advantage. If you have a pushing lane and they have a tank or something, go ahead and show up here and place that ward down, because now they have absolute agency on this top half of the map. Lorlo keeps trading with Solo, so he keeps him underneath turret. Rainover's going to kill the Blast Cone for less entrances, has this completely warded, and so now he'll pick up this red buff in just a moment, but Santorin might pop the ultimate. Let's see it.
Double lift, shifting himself out of trouble right as the root would have connected. It does connect, actually, still, but he's rooted by the time that he's already to safety.
Yeah.
Doesn't impact a whole lot of anything. One thing I'm also going to point out, Rainover did put all 3 points in the claws.
Ah!
So no mistake with the leap from him this game.
Looking for Lorlo.
Lorlo getting jumped on. Solo looking to keep the fight going. Rainover is here. Jumps back onto Solo. Looking to make it at least a trade.
Oh, not!
But he's not going to get it just yet. Flashes forward to make sure it happens. Running away from Santorin
now. Here
comes
the mids.
Help is coming. Piglet is here. Fires off the charm, but now Phoenix has made his way into the fight. Going to be brought low. Piglet having to find his way around. Phoenix got a very, very low. Hemoplank looking to trigger. Tries to eat the fruit, but Piglet's going to be brought down. A 3-for-1.
Couldn't get
Gold
him in his
Coin
belly.
United.
Couldn't get him in his belly fast enough there. And Gold Coin United, that roam, perfect. But Santorin, that was exactly where he needed to be. And Solo even got away. Almost, but got the flash. See, that's the big thing, is right? It looked like he was going to go down. but Rainover has to spend the flash to get him, which is exactly what you want. Stain doesn't have it to get out, and he's just another kill.
Mm-hmm. Two of those kills also going on to Santorin's Rengar. And when you've got a game of carry
necklace.
Jungler versus carry jungler,
necklace.
Oh, he's going to be frightening.
Yes. Making sure that he has extra stacks on that Bone Tooth, already at the two. And this right here, the flash into the Q, into the W there to make sure he doesn't have to aim the Q afterwards. You could miss it. But then Rainover has to spend the flash there. And this right here where Piglet throws out the charm, that's kind of what seals the deal here. Now he doesn't have the charm. He doesn't even have mana. He's got the Spirit Rush. And then Phoenix almost dies, but
almost isn't going to cut it.
Yeah, Piglet doesn't have the mana there. So that roam was a little bit ill-advised.
Definitely not what Liquid wanted.
I would say it was a great setup from Liquid to get the red buff, but then ultimately the follow-up afterwards, where Santorin had ulti to top lane, they went a little bit too hard to try and turn that around.
Well, it was a great turnaround for Goldcoin United, because now these guys are sitting in a 1,000 gold lead after being down almost 700 or 800. Piglet now going to be brought low by
red
Phoenix,
buff.
Who's utilizing the red buff ticks on the auto attacks to trade very aggressively. Phoenix is just crushing this mid lane.
Yeah, I'm loving that he's constantly getting those autos in there too. Now 20 CS up, and he's gone for something different than what we were seeing the other day. He's gone for the normal build of the proto belt as opposed to the Luden Zekko, which we've been seeing a little bit from some people. We saw it from Fox, and it wasn't quite as effective because this is going to make you a very tanky Vladimir that's hard to blow up, and it's also going to make it so that you hit really hard.
Health, AP, cooldown reduction, and a burst active. I honestly can't think of anything better as a whole to give to a champion like Vladimir.
Absolutely.
Really just enable them.
The CDR, everything is just so good on that. And it's pretty much a core item.
Yeah,
I would say. It's like something that if you don't have it, I'm like, what are you doing with your Vladimir life?
What are you doing with your life, man? Get that in there.
Yeah.
Solo now feeling more comfortable in his own shoes, top lane as well. Farm very even to Lorlo, considering he's been pushed in this whole time. Working on that Spectre's Cal.
Yeah, and this is what I was expecting in game two from GCU in terms of pick ban. They picked the Ahri and allowed the Karthus to be picked into it again in game two. They didn't ban it away. They didn't adjust for the Camille. And this game, they said, okay, you can take Lulu, but we'll get Rengar, and then we'll counter pick finally at the last point. And I feel like what's going to happen is if GCU wins this, they will once again select red side for game four.
And then play the strategy.
Uh-huh. And try to go for the same thing, which I thought they should have adjusted to in game two.
Better late than never.
Yeah.
At least they're still in the series by the time they adapt. Would have been a shame if those realizations happened after game number three.
Very true.
But the carrot is primed onto Solo. Lorlo will not be able to proc that one, though. Santorin hanging around up here again to make sure they can clear that ward away plenty safely as both these two now head into the enemy jungle. Liquid's got to be careful.
Look at that. Phoenix, right there. Because you're always keeping an invisible range indicator in your head of how long is that Q range from Vladimir. And he throws you off because he's got the Crimson Rush. And then
See you later, Piglet. Phoenix just gets him with style and walks away. Doesn't even bother looking back.
Yeah, and that's it right there. You keep that imaginary range indicator in your head. Flash will throw it off, but the proto belt will too. So you proto belted forward, got a large chunk with the Crimson Rush the first time, and then waited for the reset on that and made sure that he could just hemoplague, ignite, walk away.
Very smooth from Phoenix. Two-shot barrage fired off bottom side. Matt double lift, looking to make the play.
Going all in
ignite
on Matt.
Onto Mash, all the way down. They're going Wild Growth. Matt onto himself. Madlife going to be forced to flash away as well. No kills down here, but 3 out of 4 summoner spells blown on the side of Goldcoin United. Both of Matt's summoner spells used on the side of Team Liquid, so they'll come out one ahead in that trade.
Yeah, Matt, I think, missed a bit of an opportunity there and realized it a second too late because he flashed Wild Growth himself, and he only hit Madlife. He wanted to hit Mash. If he had done it a second earlier, then it would have been fine and he would have gotten both of them. But it was kind of an all-in call that wasn't all-in in that exact same moment.
Ugh, the slight lack of synergy can sometimes be the difference between getting what you need and getting a whole lot of nothing. Unfortunately for them, it was apparent. Fortunately for Goldcoin United, though, walking both those bottom laners away is going to be exactly what they need to make sure they maintain this lead that's up to almost 2K now. But double lift, in true double lift style, being the one person on the team that even if everybody else is falling behind, he's ahead.
Yeah, double lift in a lane that isn't unfavorable for him like before. Is now ahead, and that's just like the skill difference that he has between himself and Mash. Supports, though, I will say, you know, getting chunked out a whole bunch.
Like, top lane and jungle, those aren't significantly far behind. I mean, the farm is even, they're both 0-1 top side. Phoenix looking to make another play mid. Not gonna find it just yet. Still might, as soon as that empowered transfusion is up, he might be able to do it, though.
He does need to be a little bit careful because there's still Flash and Ignite on Ahri. So Santorin's around in this area. Look at this.
Uh-oh, Rainover really needs to finish this Drake off. Okay, there we go. Gets it in time. But yeah, top lane and jungle might be a little bit behind on the side of Team Liquid, but it's really all about the mid lane. That's where the gold coin advantage is. Just like we expected it to be, just like we figured if they're gonna find a win this game, it's gonna be off the back of this, and it's punishing Piglet.
Yeah, making sure that Piglet doesn't have those easy press R, gain, kill pattern on the card. Just look at that once again. Phoenix doing it.
Phoenix can't quite get in there all the way.
And that's why it's such a good item. Like, just once again, because I was baffled when Fox wasn't building this the other day, because he was looking for just movement speed. Mm-hmm. And so movement speed is fine, but people adjust in their head mentally for the distance between the two champions and how fast you're going to close that distance for the Q. This is, you always have to think about Proto Belt, which means that you always have to respect that extra 150-ish range that you get from pressing the Proto Belt, as opposed to just the smooth movement speed. So a burst is much more hard to calculate for in those moments. So
burst is always better.
Boop.
Burst is always better. The less reaction time your opponent has, the better off you're going to be.
Exactly. Like, for example, somebody will chase you down. They have Cloud Drake, my favorite, right?
Yep.
Not actually, but still, they'll chase you down, and you're like, oh my god, he's closing in on me. Oh no. And you kind of see impending doom, but you have more time to think about your life, contemplate, and maybe flash away, or maybe have something else happen, right?
As opposed to somebody just flashing at you or dashing at you or making it happen instantaneously. Goldcoin United, with that 2,000 gold threshold having been breached now, feeling good in game number 3. Only one Drake taken so far. It was the one, the Ocean Drake, that you saw Rainover sneak away ever so subtly, helping keep his team relevant as Goldcoin United maintains their lead for now. Phoenix just 40 CS up, Proto Belt, Ionian, cooldown boots, building more and more as he goes on, his opponent without even a single item completed.
Yeah, and look at what else he's doing here. Is he's going for Luden's Echo, looks like maybe next. We'll see what that ends up changing into. But he has extra movement speed here, which is great. I like that, but he has the Proto Bells. Exactly what you need. But he also has help from his team. There are control wards on both sides of mid, so Phoenix gets to push mid without giving a damn about anybody else on the map. So his team is helping him out here. That's exactly what you need.
Items are great, but teamwork makes the dream work, Zyrene.
I will say, if you're a jungler and you just want to get some extra LP, control ward mid all the time.
Constantly drop him there. Off to the side, just keep an eye on it for your mid laner. Give him as much help as you can. Shark going to be applied topside. He's going to maybe make the dive onto
Lorelo.
Lorelo's got to be careful. He needs to drop that aggro. What
oh,
in the world are these guys doing?
There's another!
Ooh. Rainover barely walking away. What a botched dive attempt from Team Liquid. Solo doing a great job outplaying these guys.
Exactly. It's a little bit too late for those early cheeky dives that we were seeing before. And Solo's on a tank versus somebody who's not as damage heavy. The Bruiser Fizz will do a decent amount, but it's that long sustained one, so you have to stay under the turret for a good while. Whereas before, it's like the Camille who gets in and out and has a way to keep you locked down.
Now, bottom lane, the power spike comparison between these two champions, you've got a Sheen and a Mana Moon versus a completed Blade of the Ruined King. So, Mash is pretty scary if they actually get into a full-on fight against these two.
Oh, that was sick. That right there. Great from the observers to show that as well, because Mash threw down a blue trinket inside of the bush that's between tier 1 and 2 turrets, and he saw Rainover. So now they get to back off, they get to bait, or they get to counter gank with a Rengar that has 2 kills.
Santorin jumping right out there. Rainover looking to continue the fight, though. He's not just going to take that lion down. True Shot Barrage continuing to try to scare these guys away, but Phoenix has made his way into the scuffle.
Yeah, Santorin actually missed his route there. I think that was a little bit slow on the inputs to actually do like a smooth Rengar combo, and he didn't go for the extra damage of the empowered Q, which is just super devastating.
Piglet can't even remotely follow Phoenix either.
No.
Phoenix goes off, Piglet's like, okay, hey team, Vlad's coming towards you, I'm gonna farm.
And another reason is he doesn't have vision control.
Right.
Phoenix can just dip into that bush that's right there on the side, and then Piglet has to clear the wave.
Good charm from Piglet, making Phoenix take a little bit of extra damage there, but Empowered Transfusion is almost up, so his health bar is not gonna be down for long.
He's zoning for the turret, making sure that They just focus on the wave. And then
Matt and Double Lift keeping themselves plenty good shape. You always got to be careful diving on to somebody who's got a Lulu next to him.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And that risk is not going to be acceptable to Gold Coin United. A good choice.
And that's why when Lulu and Rengar are both open, most teams will take Lulu because Lulu can counter the Rengar, leap in, polymorph him, whimsy him, even just using your ultimate on somebody, the Wild Growth, to knock up the Rengar if you're fast enough. Just keep that person alive.
First turret time. Goes down. Gold Coin United going to be extending that lead to 3K. Piglet's dead again.
Oh, he's dead.
Phoenix just goes ahead, throws the Proto Belt out there just to make a statement. Punctuate the sentence. Rainover bottom side. Mash going to be jumped on next. The damage coming through. The flash away. Rainover going to be creep blocked up here a little bit. Wants to come out. Oh! Mash and Madlife doing a good job staying alive.
And now they need to get out of there. That's that one turret down. They pushed a little bit further than they should have. But Phoenix gets a kill here. And look at that. He's just taking over the jungle, too. He's killing the Raptors. He's got wards inside of the jungle. And Piglet can't even go towards the wave. That's the charm down. Phoenix flashes it and just pops everything in there. And gives him a proto belt for the road.
Just making sure. 5-1, Gold Coin United, 4,000 gold up, 19 and a half minutes in. This is a different team, Zyrene.
Yeah, and this is why I was sitting there going, okay, why are you letting Piglet counter pick mid when you're red side? You have a superior mid laner, just him have
Ahri. In the lane.
Exactly, yeah. And this is just a great performance from Phoenix. Like, he is decimating 10 CS
60
per minute.
CS now.
Doing great right now, 60 up. And he's getting played around by his team. What was happening in the previous game was TL was saying, all right, Piglet, just hold tight. We're playing towards top. Rainover's ganking top constantly. But now all these wards, these control wards, have been alive for so long. There are three now around mid, with the top one also being in that pixel brush on the top side of the river.
And GCU, a 12-2 record there in the 2017 North American Challenger Series Spring Split. Now, of course, this is playing up against teams of lesser caliber than Liquid, so you can't fully expect them to have a 12-2 win percent chance here. However, that's still a very convincing record that they're able to take those leads and translate them so well.
Very convincing. And now Mountain Drake on the table as well for them to take as they're looking at these turrets and starting to rotate their bottom lane around. If they can know how to snowball leads, which is exactly what you expect from a team that's 12-2 when they have leads. And I mean, how many games do you even play in Challenger? That's 14 games right there.
Yeah, that's a lot.
That's pretty much the majority of their games sans playoffs.
Well, they've secured themselves the Mountain Drake. That'll be the second Elemental Drake this game. Ties that count up 1-1. Baron alive now, 21 minutes into the match. Gold Coin might be looking to consider that potential sometime soon. But Liquid are the ones who are actually doing a sneaky attempt onto it. Ping's coming out.
Yeah, I think they have some idea, so Vladimir's going to run in here and check.
Gold Coin United knows they're going to be shutting this down right now.
Yeah, and that you can see the desperation is starting to creep up. It's a 4,000 gold advantage for GCU, but they have priority mid. They have all these wards around it that have slowly been taken over and cleared out, but they'll eventually get this turret if they keep pushing, and they can bring Mash up.
Phoenix is just such a huge presence for this team right now. If you look at everything else, top laners are very similar. Junglers are in a similar spot. AD carries are in a similar spot. Supports are in a similar spot. But man, the mid lane is just the difference this game.
Yeah.
It's like you're not even watching the same two players at all.
And when you think about teams that are on the elite level, it's so hard to think about a team that's on the elite level that didn't have a great mid laner.
Yeah. Right? It's so critical.
Most you can get is something like Rocks Tigers back in the day with Kuro. Not exactly an elite mid laner, but they were
not
able
compared
to
the rest of the team, at least.
Mm-hmm. Well, was able to kind of hold his own. Sometimes, you know, he would be a liability, but you think about all the other teams, people definitely played around mid lane. Because if you lose mid just naturally by the guy having, you know, less skill in the matchups, less knowledge, then the whole game collapses. And that's why people usually look at the mid as the superstar role.
Piglet not having a superstar performance so far this game. Morello Namakon done now, though. Means if they can get that Vladimir a little bit lower, they'll have some more healing control over him. But with a Luden's Echo and a Proto Belt and a Spectre's Cowl done on Phoenix, I've said no comparison a couple of times, but there's really just no words to describe it any better. The Vladimir, so frightening. Hemo Plague, Ignite, everything's ready to go. You got 10 summoner spells ready to fire on the side of Gold Coin United. 10 summoner spells ready to go on the side of Team Liquid as well. Well, 9. Matt's still got his flash charging up a little bit further here.
One of the great things about Vladimir is people who play Vladimir a lot will know his damage. Other people won't always know how much damage he's doing at all points in the game. And he'll take you by surprise because he's tanky and you assume, oh, he wouldn't be doing that much damage. But he bursts you. It's one of the reasons that like Storm Raider's Kog'Maw is actually a good pick, because he'll burst you. And then once you realize, oh, shoot, he's bursted me, he's got extra movement speed to chase you down.
Yeah, and then you just die.
Yep.
You're not really getting away from it at that point. Solo keeps trying to find these engage opportunities on the double lift, but just can't quite get them. Santorin trying to steal away this blue buff, or at least force Rain over to smite it so Piglet doesn't get it.
Yep.
He at least gets goal number two. The siege continues, though, as Goldcoin United will not alleviate pressure upon this tier one. They want to make sure that they're constantly threatening something. They know that they've got an advantage in this game. You don't just want to sit back and allow your opponents to catch up, take this to a 45-minute, 50-minute coin flip kind of a game. Instead, push that lead, do everything with it you can. Both top laners now setting up here on the bottom side of the map. TP's ready to go.
Yeah, Bruiser Fizz only tickling right now. And you can see Lorlo's not going for like that full Bruiser build where you get like a Frozen Heart. You also go for a Blade of the Rune King for extra attack speed. And I mean, Blade of the Rune King did get buffed, or changed, I guess. To
a lot of people consider it a buff.
Really like it. He's going for a bit.
Solo goes right back in, though. Not super concerned about it.
He's not winning these anymore. There's a good mix of armor and magic resistance now for Solo.
Well, Solo is... if this is the world that he can live in, where he can just set up here against Lorlo, defend easily, not have his health bar constantly threatened, not have his turret constantly threatened, this is fine. Because then once they get into a team fight, once he TPs into the fight, he's going to be this huge disruptor, this big front line. And Lorlo's just going to have to try to find his way into the back line.
And it's not going to be the easiest thing, too, because they have a Karma. Karma can just root him, and that will go through the Playful Trickster, unless he does it right at the last point. But usually to get in, you'll have to use the Playful Trickster, too.
Goldcoin bringing that lead up to 5k. They got a Drake spawning here in about 80 seconds. Two turrets to zero. Liquid still yet to get themselves on the objectives board with anything except for that Ocean Drake that they got very early on from Rainover Sneak. Rainover also getting himself just a little bit tankier.
Phoenix, he's just going to zone now from around the turret. This guy...
Piglet can't even get close.
Yeah, he's got rank 3 ultimate. He's 2 levels up over Piglet. He has Ignite. He's got Protobell. He's got everything.
Like, Piglet just isn't allowed to play League of Legends if Phoenix is also playing League of Legends nearby. It's really rough. Like, that's a really rough situation to be in. And Phoenix knows it. Like, he's totally in control of this situation.
Mm-hmm.
26 minutes into the game, though, keep in mind that every minute we tick on, Baron becomes that much more of a reasonable objective. And eventually, these guys are going to decide to pull the trigger on it, one side or the other. You already saw Liquid attempt it earlier, but they just didn't have the damage, not at 21 minutes. Rainover taken down about 1/3.
Mash
going to be forced back. Double lifted Matt, can't chase it any further. True Shot Barrage comes out, but the shield's going to keep him alive. TL taking his chance to push themselves up a little bit further. Double lift continuing to fire those Mystic shots into Santorin. He's very far up. Phoenix coming in from the side, but Vlad has no hard CC in the kit, so I don't really see him finding an opportunity on the double lift here.
Yeah, just going to provide a whole lot of damage. And then the Mountain Drake comes up in 5 seconds. Mash had to back, Santorin had to back. This gives position slightly to TL, but I feel like because they're so far behind, you just get to walk in as GCU and push them off that position.
Yeah, when you've got a 5k gold lead, they need to at least kill somebody to go for something like that.
And right now, Double Lift is kind of the saving grace for TL. He's up in CS, he has Executioner's Calling, he has 2 items, so I believe he's actually a little bit ahead of where Mash is, or was before, has the Monomune done.
And you know, I really like the early Executioner's Calling like this. Even if you don't bother to compare it into Mortal Reminder for a while, that Vladimir, considering how I've already said 2 different times, you know, the Vlad is the game. Like, that's what Goldcoin is playing around. If you can shut down that healing, because the Executioner's Calling is not conditional. You just tag him with physical damage and it automatically applies. You don't have to wait for him to be below a certain health threshold like the Morello Nomicon. You just automatically get that.
Yeah, it lasts 3 seconds, and when you get the Mortal Reminder, it actually lasts longer than that. But during that 3, if you're constantly, if that's your main target, like you said, and there aren't too many others, it's a good plan, but hold on, look at this.
This is not a good plan, though. Liquid tries to trade the Baron for their tier 1, but Goldcoin just takes the tier 1 and says, okay, you can't have Baron, though, sorry. Not going to be working out that way. Phoenix and Doublelift with a quick trade back and forth.
And you can see how much less HP Phoenix got there because of the fact that the Grievous Wounds was on him, reducing it by 40%.
but that's just more gold in the pockets of Gold Coin United. That's just a bigger lead that they have, and all they need is to take things slowly, play them carefully, play them correctly. And if they're playing that methodical game, they can continue building this lead to the point where Phoenix is going to be 6 items and Piglet is going to be 3. And it's going to be really hard.
We're getting there, yeah.
To make up that difference.
I just looked at the gold. It's 2,400, and Phoenix just spent a bit of it. So now we're looking at...
All right, maybe not 6 items to 3. 6 items to 4.
It's 3,000 gold up, so he's a full item up.
All right, Rainover and Santorin, both in this Dragon Pit. Rainover trying to get the Drake low enough to make it a 50-50, but Santorin says, get the hell out of here. This is Gold Coin United territory.
Yeah, beat it.
Yeah,
get him.
Beat it. Good old school 80s movie, a turf war.
Oh, man, just made me think of West Side Story.
That's their turf, though.
Yeah. I wonder if they dance fight.
A dance fight between Rengar and Kha'Zix over that Earth Drake?
Oh, no, there'd be blood in that one.
Oh. I was going to say, this is in the lore, Zyrene. It's not a dance. All right. Back to the rest of the teams, though. Double lift. 0-0-0, 29 minutes into the game, but the one that these guys are depending on, working on his Blade of the Ruined King next. It's a nice part about Vladimir as well. Stacks so much health, but not a lot of armor. I mean, he's got the Zonyas, but that's all he's going to have. So the Blade of the Ruined King is going to make a serious impact.
Yeah, Blade of the Ruined King is definitely going to help when Doublelift completes that. But like you said, he does have some armor. Very high up in levels right now. He's almost level 18. Ooh, Nash just taking big chunks there, but also getting a bit of the HP out of Doublelift and Matt. Yeah, Phoenix now has a lot of HP. He's got a lot of magic resistance, and he's got a decent amount of armor. So he's cresting that point where he's deceptively tanky and will constantly heal during these fights, especially with something like a Hemo Plague.
Lorlo just barely got himself back there as Solo rounded the corner and tried to stop his recall, but being able to get himself back, heal up, chop up, come back to lane that much more effective could be very important for him as this Solo contest continues between these two. Guardian Angel up and running on Solo himself. The next time he gets into one of these big team fights, it is just going to be nigh impossible to do anything to this guy, especially with Doublelift still not having Blade of the Ruined King completed.
Yeah, and it feels like GCU, they have an advantage, but they're struggling to figure out how to push that advantage right now. They were not the ones who were positioned around Baron until about now. They've been getting those Drakes, which is great, but they have 2 Mountain Drakes. Like, they should feel comfortable setting up a Baron, whether it's a bait, baiting out blue trinkets, and just spending the next 2 minutes or so doing something like that, because they have side wave pressure because of Vladimir, and they should have it as well because they're Nautilus.
And that's something that you actually see as a pretty big point of contrast between a lot of lower level LCS teams / challenger teams and higher level LCS teams, is teams that know how to take a smaller and smaller lead and make bigger and bigger things out of it. Like, the best teams will take a 1,000 gold lead and just run away with the game, while some other teams have a bit more difficulty translating that. You can have a 5,000 gold lead and not actually turn it into anything super meaningful.
Yeah, you get those 2 kills on Rengar, get 2 stacks of Bone Tooth Necklace. Some guys start snowballing off of that. Right here, though, this is a great setup. GCU gonna have to fight.
Into the fight they go. Piglet gonna be bursted down. Wild Growth keeping him alive for the time being. Phoenix into the back line, gonna be bringing Matt very low. Hemo Plague onto multiple targets. Doublelift over the wall, staying alive. But what is he gonna do alone? Lorlo gonna be a hop, skip, and a jump away from the fight, but Santorin still after him. 2 dead on the side of Team Liquid. GCU looking clean.
Yep, just baiting it out, making sure that they have a fight. It wasn't really the cleanest of Baron baits. It was kind of one where, hey, we haven't cleared everything out, but let's just go for it. Let's just try. And they do. They get 2 kills, still 3 up. Phoenix
really wanted to go after Rain over here. Eliminate that steal potential. Doublelift trying to poke as much as he can. Phoenix gonna be going into the pool. Mad Life keeping Lorlo locked down. Blue team double steal. Baron Nashor. Doublelift grabbing the kill onto Santorin, so it's a 2-for-1, but the steal away. Rain over the hero.
Yeah, and that's going to be Lorlo actually taking it, walking away with it. Matt spawns a little bit too late, so they have 1 Baron buff, and they got the gold for Baron, but they lost 4 in the process.
That steal from Rainover may have just saved the game.
Yeah, may have saved TL, because now they don't have to be pushed in on all lanes. Maybe they get some of these turrets back. We've been talking about the turret count. 3-1 right now. There's gold on the map for the taking. TL could pick that up after this. Phoenix zones away, uses the E. Doublelift just kind of throwing pop shots in there. And then they focus Phoenix, trying to get him down. And that's just a flash in from Rainover to go for the kill onto the Baron as Doublelift goes in. and tries to get Santorin.
That's the hero play, and you've got to make those when you're behind like that. It pays off just absolutely huge for Team Liquid. Lowering the gold gap very slightly. Lorlo, the one guy that they've still got the Baron buff up and running on. So as he's in this split push situation against Solo, it's going to be that much harder for Nautilus to deal with those minions from Lorlo, effectively smack those down as the Nautilus. But I was honestly not even watching Baron's health because I saw Rainover fighting against Phoenix, and I was like, oh, he's zoned away, everything's fine. And then Flash in the steel caught me by surprise.
Yeah, Santorin didn't even get a chance to smite. Rainover caught.
Rainover wants to run away from this one. They're trying to start the fight off on him, though. I don't think he's going to be tanky enough to survive. This one unstoppable for Phoenix. Goldcoin United looking to take it even deeper. Matt going to be going down next. Make it Piglet 2. A double kill for Phoenix. Only two left standing on the side of Team Liquid. Goldcoin United adamant about taking this to game four.
And Goldcoin United have two Mountain Drakes. And now they're going to be able to push this up. That Baron buff is still on Lorlo. So he'll be able to actually buff these up. Make it a little bit harder to push in.
I mean, a little bit harder, but you're still in a 2 versus 5 for 20 seconds. Goldcoin wants to end this game. Double lift Arcane shifting himself out of the consequences of the dredge line. He still gets pulled in a little bit, but won't be locked down. Goldcoin pushing towards that Nexus. They're saying, hey, let's end the game. Let's go. Double lift again. Going to be getting away from the lockdown. Mash and the rest of Goldcoin United hanging around, bringing down Nexus turret number one. Double lift getting off as many auto attacks as he can. Shark going to be dodged away with a good Sanguine pull from Phoenix. Lorlo trying to chase down more, trying to punish these guys. They've essentially got to at this point. They can't allow Goldcoin United to just walk away from this one, but where is the chase potential actually at? Slow's connecting. Lorlo's still trying to go in. Wild Growth going to be cast onto him. Emo playing down. The counterattack begins. Goldcoin United looking to win the game right now. The Phoenix going to be brought down first. Devil is still alive in the back part of the fight. Goldcoin United in full retreat. True Shot Barrage! A double kill for Lorlo. Solo's going to be going down next. Madlife trying to get away, but Lorlo grabs a triple and says, no, you don't. Solo can't fight all three, and goodness gracious, Team Liquid gets four.
And they rout them completely. Mash has to back up. They're going to start looking at this turret in mid lane. Huge turnaround. They stole the Baron, gave him enough time to keep their base intact because Lorlo kept that buff up, and then they respawn. The slows constantly from Rainover. The damage comes through, and they're able to focus down Phoenix so quickly.
Phoenix dying for the first time this game, 35 minutes in, is just what the doctor ordered for Team Liquid. Now they're writing a prescription for outer turrets. The gold lead is shrinking back down to a manageable level. Still got 5 seconds before the rest of the members of Goldcoin United come back alive, which should be more than enough time for Double Lift and Matt to take down this tier two. Baron power play, 422 gold.
Well, it's the Baron power play where they lost four people. They're gonna get a Drake off this. They're gonna actually get a lot of turrets. And GCU overextended there. And they got punished. It was a beautiful fight there from TL. Let's watch how Phoenix gets caught here. Tries to go in, gets Polymorph, Whimsied. Then, I believe there's a charm in there too that stops him from casting anything, and the Hemoplague did not go off in time.
He had his Empowered Transfusion ready too. If he had even a split second, if he had even a split second there, he was going to be set to bait that fight in and just end the game. But instead, a triple kill for Lorlo ends up sealing the fate of Goldcoin United, who were just now knocking at the doors of the Nexus for Team Liquid, but have now got to continue their push all over again, pushing down that top side now. The tier two going to fall. That's their seventh turret this game. Still in a position of power, still in a spot where they feel comfortable being the ones to determine the tempo and the pace of this game. Lorlo hanging around bottom side. He's got TP ready and available to join the fight. Solo, however, has to hang out with the rest of Goldcoin because his TP is not going to be back for another minute.
And this game just got really scary for Goldcoin United.
You were talking
about how the items were going to be a huge difference between them. Gap closed a little bit in that mid lane. Top lane, though, advantage for Lorlo. Solo.
Okay, Solo, this is really bad. He has no Guardian Angel. He's going to be brought down. Phoenix could be next. Hemoplague still ticking. Charm not going to be finding the mark. Still going in. Still going deeper. Still looking to make more happen. Still looking to grab Madlife. He gets taken very low. Polymorph onto Phoenix. Liquid trying to chase this further. Not going to be finding it just yet. This is match point, Zyrene. If Team Liquid wins this game, it's over.
They want it. They want to be back in the LCS. They caught Solo, and they almost caught Phoenix there. They got his flash, which could be a setup for the near future because there's 1 minute on that Baron.
This whole game, the sense of things for Team Liquid has not been one of a game that's imperative. It has not been a sense of do or die right here, right now. If you lose this game, you've still got two more chances to find one win. Gold Coin United has had nothing but a strict demand on them to win this game. They must complete the reverse sweep. They cannot afford a throw at the 11th hour of this game.
And we were looking at something that was like a 7,000 gold lead, and it was just getting worse and worse. And now it's 1,500. Just this small difference. Smash looks to double lift.
Double lift, eating a little damage, shifts himself away in time. Luckily wasn't shopping or anything like that. So gets himself away safely.
Pro tip for people who like to shop, you can actually make your shop smaller, make it take half of your screen. So when you hit back and you hit shop,
see
your character still.
Phoenix popping a Sanguine Pool, trying to get himself away. Still has the Zhonya's Hourglass if it's needed. Lorlo and Rainover on the front line. Mash off to the side, gonna be unleashing the calling. Team Liquid might have gone a little bit too far into this one. Rainover gonna be losing the Guardian Angel. Piglet makes his way into the fight. Now the Hemo play gonna be dropped. Santorin and Phoenix goes back.
Phoenix!
He's down! Santorin, the Guardian Angel, popped. Team Liquid trying to do even more. Santorin will not make it away from this one. It's a 2-0, a 5-3 push. The story for Team Liquid. Double lift at full HP.
The first pick, Lulu, came up huge there. Matt, he's whimsying every time on Phoenix. Right when he wants to rush in, he's got the Crimson Rush. He would heal so much, but he shuts it down. And that may be the game. They already took out two really fed members. TL, Quant back in the LCS.
Nexus turret number one is done. Madlife gonna be going down very soon if he's not careful. More damage fired off from those Void Spikes. Solo's gotta be on the front line and stop them here. Hold the line, Gold Coin, or this is it. Right over into the back line. Jumps around, finds the kill onto one. Lorlo gonna be shot down. Mash able to get that one. Two left alive on the side of Team Liquid.
Mash
has got to go hero mode right now.
Oh!
But he can't quite get it all
just
done.
That.
But he gets double. He's got the triple, and he cannot lose today. Not to that. Not now.
Not like this.
Gold Coin United will hold the line.
They hold on just barely. That's inhibitor down. Their base is being destroyed on the other side. If Gold Coin United might be able to do something here. That base is in shambles.
Team Liquid.
He's rushing it. Santorin's like, let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Crashing into their base at two different angles. Once from the top, once from the bottom.
Doesn't
the bottom.
Seconds.
Colliding onto the
Santorin's
open
gonna
nexus.
Try to end it right here. He's going to have solo TP in afterwards.
Stop this. Hero mode Lulu. Fasten that squid hat tight. You got to buy 8 seconds. Santorin going deep.
Four, three, two. He's got it. He's got it.
Matt has managed to hold.
They go to the top side, though. This gigantic wave took the turret. It took the inhibitor. Matt bought enough time there. He was the hero of the fight, and he was the hero of the recovery. Piglet, looking for the charm.
The hero of the day for Team Liquid keeps that Nexus alive. 55 seconds before Santorin is back in the game. Team Liquid, they've got an inhibitor. With 5% HP remaining, they've got an injured Nexus. They've got an inhibitor down. They've got an injured enemy Nexus.
There's a few seconds on Lorlo's teleport, and there's a ward all the way down mid lane for TL. They just have to stop Vax, wait for it, but they're gonna try to go for a fight win.
Oh, the fight is going off. Remember, it's gonna be a 5-4. Phoenix trying to do everything he can as this fed Vladimir. Massive minion wave heading towards the Nexus of Team Liquid right now. Redemption being used. Phoenix gonna be kept alive. Look at the minion wave on the Nexus. Somebody's gonna stop
this. Solo's gonna TP too. He's gonna try to end the game right now.
Solo's gonna TP right back into this. See if he can stop it. Lorlo's gonna get back to the base. Team Liquid gonna be losing this potentially right off of this. Solo hammering onto it. Lorlo's gonna stop the minions.
Double lift
the aggroed. Lorlo trying to maintain the aggro for as long as possible onto those super minions. Solo's gonna be burned down. The Guardian Angel will keep him alive just a moment longer in just a second.
And what do you do with this guy?
Barrage fired off. Solo's gonna be brought down.
Baron
Liquid
started up.
Liquid will hold. What a match. Zyrene. Baron now started by Gold Coin United. Down to half HP. Nobody from Liquid around in time to stop this one. It should go their way. Gold Coin picks that one up for themselves. Ping's coming out from Liquid onto the Elder Drake. That's gonna be the next call.
This is ridiculous. Both teams have a naked Nexus inhibitor down so that minions are constantly going to push in different lanes, and you have to be able to grab objectives and make sure that you defend that Nexus that almost anyone could kill given enough time.
This is a game of a million moments. So many different times, either team looked like they were on the cusp, the precipice. But we're still going, 43 minutes in, 14 to 16. The gold is dead even, 79-2 to 79-2. Neither team willing to give an inch. But Team Liquid will take a mile if they can walk away with this one, go 3-0 against Goldcoin United and get the hell out of the promotion tournament. Goldcoin United, though, they want to keep this going. They want to be that team instead.
Yeah.
Liquid has to answer this bottom lane wave of minions.
We're seeing the reset, too. There's an inhibitor down on the bottom side for TL. It is coming up very shortly. GCU's inhibitor already back up. GCU has the Baron. TL has the Elder Dragon, so they have less time to work with this buff when they want to fight.
Cyrene, I was talking to you when I came back from the break between games, and I said, you know what? I went to use the restroom, and they were playing One Winged Angel in there. As soon as I heard that, I knew it was going to be an omen, that we were going to see some intense stuff today. It's one of those kinds of days. You cannot tell me that Liquid versus Goldcoin United game number three will not have an epic finale.
Don't get me started on the brilliance of Nobuo Uematsu, dude. That stuff's my jam. I love me.
You and
some
me both.
Fantasy music. But like you said, this game is insane. It is so close between these two teams. And GCU, they play to stay alive in this match. TL, like you said, they just want this over with. They want to be back in the LCS. They want to be able to go back to their beds. A sigh of relief.
The Nexus is the jugular for Team Liquid. That's, you just, everything's over at this.
We've seen both teams try to go for the jugular already.
Yeah,
hasn't worked out.
But for Goldcoin United, the Liquid Nexus isn't even the jugular. It's like the foot. You've got to stab them in that so you can keep fighting them.
Hopefully they're Achilles and you get that tendon.
Yeah, there we go.
But
a mythological reference.
Yeah. Lorelo on the bottom side, pushing up. Why go through the hot gates of Thermopylae when you can just go around?
Hey, we got a horse. Let it into your face.
Oh. Now they're just trying to find more avenues in. They're going to push between mid and bottom. Control here for TL in terms of how much vision they have throughout the jungle.
Elder Drake is almost expired. It's
going
to wear off any second,
and
that's what Goldcoin has been waiting on. They sat out their own Baron buff, just making sure that there was no way they were going to be fighting with that true damage burn on. Two Ocean Drakes to two Mountain Drakes means both sides have a decent Elder. Charm comes out, does not find its way onto Mash, who pops the Culling. Goldcoin United just marching straight down mid lane. Inhibitors alive on both sides.
Yeah, you messed up once, you done goof. That's it.
Rainover jumps over to join his team.
This
fast track on the mid lane for Goldcoin United. There's still a turret standing there, though.
Yep.
Well, two turrets standing there.
So we talked about Elder Dragon versus the Baron buff. Baron's going to last longer. Just wore off after that. They got the turret. Now they only have this Nexus, or this inhibitor turret.
Baron's gone. Solo flashing away to make sure he stays safe enough.
Phoenix QSS.
There's so many full builds in this game right now, Zyrene. Rainover and Lorelo are one to jump in and start this fight. Maybe just see if they can blow some kind of a cooldown. Lorelo gonna be wild growth. He's in the front line, but he's still
Phoenix in
damage. Hemoplank onto the back line. Phoenix looking to make this game happen. True Shot Barrage fired off. Lorelo's gonna be losing his Guardian Angel. Solo trying to re-engage the fight. Lorelo hopping away. Goldcoin United is gonna be very respectful of what Double Limp can do with these mystic shots. Goldcoin trying to retreat.
Phoenix
gonna be charmed! Sanguine pool in time. Double Limp again gonna be looking for damage. Another Guardian Angel going down. Rainover losing that one. 2 second lives being popped on the side of Team Liquid. They want to find more off the back of this.
Inhibitor.
The inhibitor dying in the top part of the map, though. Lorelo looking to make the moves here on to Mash. Mash immediately returns fire. Top lane inhibitor will likely fall here on the side of Team Liquid. The minions destroy it alone. And Goldcoin United takes down an enemy inhibitor and two Guardian Angels. They will take that fight.
And now those GAs still up on GCU. The gold really doesn't matter right now.
Yeah, gold doesn't mean anything. We're at the point where pretty much everybody's full build.
It's getting there.
Full build Fizz, full build Kha'Zix, almost full build Ahri, full build Ezreal. Lulu and Karma. Well, wait, Karma's actually there. Lulu's not quite.
Yeah. When. Just like that, Lulu bought Art Sensor.
All right, now Lulu's there.
Yeah, we consider three control wards part of a support's full build. They're there. It's just every here and there, like Santorin solo. Even Phoenix, the QSS, still could use a little bit more, but.
These fights are teetering on a razor's edge.
It's execution that really matters.
It is. That's all that it's going to come down to. Which team does it right? And can the other team do it righter?
Righter.
Righter. Level of rightness. And the way the team fight is done is going to determine which Nexus falls and which stands here. Lots of powerful shields coming out from Mad Life.
And right now, GCU are actually in a great position.
They're strong. They know they've got a 7 versus 5 with GAs.
Exactly. They also have Super Minions pushing top, and they're going to rush it. They don't think they can get back here in time to actually do it. They're
going
to try to.
They're just going to end the game.
Away.
They're rushing straight for the Nexus. Looking to end this match. Is that Big going to be blown up?
Mash on Double
Growth, keeping him alive. Mash versus Double Up. It's going to fall. Gold Coin United onto the Nexus. Still looking to make this game end. Team Liquid having to
fall in.
Having to try to stop them. They're not going to be doing it. Game 4.
Insane ending there. GCU go for broke. It was now or never. And they hold on. No LCS for TL just yet.
Gold Coin United, not a team to be clean swept through this match in the promotion tournament. Instead, saying we're going to see you guys in game number 4 with the decisive finale in what was truly a close game.
Get your picks and bands ready, bro.
Best be ready for this final match. This is going to be absolutely not final match. Could be second to final match,
right? It's one of those things where we were coming in and it's like, okay, if they're going to stay with the same pick ban strategy, TL is going to take this. GCU swap it up. They get large leads from Phoenix. They start snowballing, not fast enough, and then they have a few throws. TL has some great plays with the steal around Baron, the counter on the push on bottom lane, and then they turn it around, and that's where GCU have to go for broke. TL was on the Nexus. They almost had the Nexus. Mash got a few autos in there against Doublelift. They killed each other, and it was just in time. Mash saved that game in those moments.
The fact that the bullets are flying through the air at the same time and then they both die, that was it. If he didn't kill Doublelift right there, the game was over.
Yeah.
The series was over. The day. Here on NALCS1 was over.
It just went really sad.
Yeah,
it's over.
It's all over. But it's not over. And for an in-depth look on what just happened in that crazy GCU win, we're going to send things over to the analysts.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. A huge victory there for GCU in a very tense back-and-forth game. They talk about there at the end, you know, the series being a single kill away from ending. I mean, there was like 12 different points in that game where the series or the game almost ended.
Yeah, I mean, it was ridiculously close down the stretch, but if you can't win this game where Phoenix is smashing Piglet about as hard as it is possible, then what game can you win?
Right. So that would be the worrying thing looking ahead to the next two games is like we had such a good start like that with a comp like that, and it was that tough for us to win it. But I do have to say I like the adjustments out of GCU moving into this game, as we mentioned, putting him on something like the Vladimir and getting Piglet off of the Karthus.
Yeah, I think banning out the Karthus, taking away that comfort pick makes a lot of sense. And I just like having Phoenix on a team fighter where he can actually very easily extend his lead into the team fight stage, into that advantage. You know, part of the tough part for GCU was actually forcing those team fights, though. I think Liquid did a good job of kind of stalling out the game and not letting it go too far. that said,
Zyrene,
I mean, Phoenix
back
had
at you, buddy.
Such a good game.
Absolutely. It is unfortunate though. Team Liquid didn't realize that Gangplank is basically an AD Karthus. Probably could have substituted that one right in there in the team comp. But as you mentioned, you know, the lead is built for GCU, and then we saw a bit of a stall out. And this is something, you know, a trend that we typically see with either lower tier LCS teams or challenger teams is that okay, we've got a lead. How exactly do we push it forward? And part of that is identifying how the comp needs to push the lead, right? Because that can differ by strategy. And someone like Vladimir, they opted to put him in a side lane and really go for those split pushes. You got a team fight.
Yeah, and this was the way that they were going to force that team fight, is bring it to the Baron, turn and fight. You have an exceptionally strong Vladimir. That's a good way to do it. And, you know, the initial stages of this fight went very well for them. You know, Piglet with, like, a borderline intentionally feeding play there. Like,
yeah.
that was actually insane. I mean, he's 0-3 and 0 at this point, down, like, 70 CS. He flashed ult in the middle of five people. What are you going to do in that situation on Ahri?
Yeah.
It's almost never going to work. So he suicides. The only thing that saves this game for a while is the fact that Rainover is able to get in, able to steal away the Baron, because I think the game would have ended with this Baron.
Absolutely. I agree 100%. If the Baron falls the other way, along with the kills that they picked up, that would give them the map advantage to actually push forward. This stalls it out another 5 minutes. They are left with one remaining Baron buff on Team Liquid. That gives them the opportunity to finally push forward, pick up some turrets. And then the game started to devolve into chaos off the back end of a big comeback fight from Team Liquid. Bot lane 4-0, chasing GCU out of the base. With this, they got plenty of time along with this Baron to kind of even up the gold advantage and make it a game.
And I mean, the biggest thing to track here is Vladarin. He's the Fed member, gets polymorphed up. The charm nicely overlap with that. It means he can't get his Zhonya's off. He can't actually start getting through those cycles with spells.
Yep.
And that's where most of the gold lead was. So as soon as he goes down, they're able to kind of chase in, pick up a lot of kills. And I think that, you know, a lot of credit does go to Matt and Piglet for actually properly executing that.
Very
that was well
point.
Done. And even forcing a QSS out later in the game because they had been crowd controlling him very well.
Right.
But you can see how strong the Vladimir was, you know, doing so much damage for his team. Obviously, double lift was very strong. I think it's tough late in the game for Vladimir. Not that the champion is weak late game per se, but when Locket comes in, when Redemption comes in.
We like, saw multiple fights where
healing debuffs, you know, your AoE gets negated so heavily by these powerful support items.
Absolutely. But we return to the original, you know, question as to whether or not Gold Coin United can actually repeat this win two more times. Because when I look at that gold graph, that's never a gold graph that I want to see in a victory, where we are up a ridiculous amount of gold at 35 minutes, as you mentioned. If that Baron fight goes the other way, we end the game there, essentially, and then have it make its way all the way back to the other team's favor come the end of the game. They got to find a way to act with more composure through the mid game.
Yeah, I agree. They certainly do. But you know, one of the things that gives me some faith in Gold Coin United as far as this having some repeatability is that Phoenix is smashing Piglet like this every game.
True.
Even in the losses, he absolutely blasted him on Ahri. He took the turrets. I think that if you put him on team fighters, if you put him in his position to succeed, you know, you can get those advantages and take over games. Because like we said, if they had hit that Baron smite, it would have been ended very early.
Yep.
And looked like a much more convincing game.
Absolutely. It's Team Liquid's turn to respond now, come up with a new strategy and answer for Gold Coin United. But they were able to pick up this game and take us to a game four. Stick around after the break. We can see if they can take the series against Team Liquid to a game five, or if Liquid walks away with it. We'll be right back.
Come on, through, walk through.
Fucking end!
Yeah, good job, guys. Good job.